Dr. Andy Galpin here. We're back doing 5-Minute Physio. Today's topic, how to determine whether or not you're using good or bad exercise technique. This is really important because we always talk about this, and I don't know a coach on the planet who ever advises someone that it's okay or to use bad technique. But what we fail to do is actually talk about what the hell is good technique or bad technique. Now, I can give you 100 hours worth of information on every single exercise variation, and we could go through good and bad technique in that variation. But what I like to do actually is to give pathways of thinking or scaffolding. So this is scaffolding I use, or the rubric I should say that I use to determine, no matter what the exercise is, whether or not I'm using good or bad technique. So let me go through these in a quick fashion. The first one is understanding the purpose of the exercise. Now, we could probably stop right here because a lot of people don't pay attention to this when they actually write the damn program in the first place. But let's hope you have a coach that you're working with, or you are a coach, and you have a very clear understanding of the exact purpose of the exercise, the exact position of the body, why I'm using this grip versus this grip, why I'm here with my stance versus here with my stance. A quick example of that. Let's take the high bar back squat versus the low bar back squat. So if you know anything about those, the high bar back squat often used in things like Olympic lifting is a very vertical torso. Your knees go very far over top of your toes so that you can stay very vertical because the bar is directly up on your back, really high. Okay, that's very, very different than what would be more like a powerlifting style or low bar back squat where the bar goes low down your back. So in order to keep the bar from rolling off your back, you lean forward. All right, so what happens is your knees actually stay fairly behind your toes, your hips go way back, and you almost do like this hybrid good morning squatting style. Now, those things are significantly different. If you have an athlete and they're squatting, and you want to know are they using good technique or not, we have to understand, are we trying to do a more glute or hip dominant squatting style? Are we trying to keep the shins vertical to ease the burden of the knees? If so, I should be sitting back using this low bar squat technique. If not, maybe I'm trying to keep it easier on my back because right as I do the low bar squatting style, even though it's easier on my knees, it's probably more difficult on my low back because I create what's called a shearing force. For the barbell is here and the weight's here, it's difficult for my low back. Right? So there's pros and cons to every single thing you do. Every footwear you use, every belt you use, every strap you use. Right? This all changes. We have to understand what's the purpose of the exercise. Second thing I'm paying attention, are we going through the desired range of motion? Now, most of the time, our default pattern should be full range of motion, right through each joint. We want every joint going through the range of motion it was designed to go through. But we have to realize that all of our range of motions are different. And there are some times when I don't necessarily want to go through the full range of motion. We'll talk about all the reasons for that in maybe a separate video. But we have to understand, again, what was the point of this exercise program or selection? What was the point, and did I hit the desired range of motion? Not any further, not any less. Number three, movement quality. Now, this is a four-step system. I'm not going to go through it now. We all use different things to determine movement quality. But for me, it's number one, awareness. Is the athlete aware of the body position they're in, wherever that may be? Number two, are they flexible? So can they hit the right positions while keeping all of their joints, ligaments, tendons, all their muscles in the position we want them to be in? Number three, are they symmetrical, right? This is usually front, back, or left and right. So is one knee out there, the other one's over here. Is one side higher than the other? Things like that. And number four, are they stable? So in those positions, are they getting excessive wobbling? A good example of this, when you're squatting, maybe you're hitting full range of motion, everything's in a good position, but your knees wobble a lot on the way up. So maybe we're losing stability, things like that. If I can check all those things off, if I'm aware of the position I'm supposed to be in, I've got good flexibility to get into the right range of motion in proper positions, which generally means spine neutral, everything else moving properly. Am I symmetrical between front and back, side to side, left and right? And am I stable? If we've passed all three of those, the last thing I worry about is equipment alignment. So if I imagine you've all been through this where you've misloaded, right? You go to pick up a bar and all of a sudden one side goes up and the other doesn't go up because your training partner or you forgot to tell them. If I grab two sets of dumbbells and I grab a 45 and then a 35, things like that, right? That can lead to some poor quality movement. Now, sometimes we want to do that on purpose, which is cool, another video. But in general, we want to make sure we're aligned. So that's my four-point system. If you apply this to any exercise you're using, it's going to help you determine immediately whether or not your athlete's using good technique or bad technique. Go ahead and get at me on social media, Twitter and Instagram, at drandygalpin.com, or check out the website, andygalpin.com, if you're not there right now. Let me know what you want to see next, and check back for an expanded version. I'll probably do a 25-minute physiology and a 55-minute physiology of this as well, so you can get into this stuff in more depth. For now, we'll call this good with our 5 minutes.